We're live at Beaver Stadium in State College, Pennsylvania, tucked in the Nittany Valley between Bald Eagle Mountain and Tussie Mountain. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Iowa is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Allen from the four. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. Penn State's coaching staff, the fans, I think everybody's been waiting to see this kid play, and here he is.
Well, he's a star quarterback. He seems to bring everything to the table. The crowd, I think, senses he's ready to have a big day. And when your star quarterback feels good and playing at home and he gets off to a good start, some big things can happen for this offense.
And he has it on the corner. He's taken off. And he's tackled around the 45-yard line.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
From their own 45-yard line, first down. He lets it fly. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
He's at the 40. He's tackled around the 33-yard line. From the 33-yard line, first down. He's at the 20, and down he goes at the 19. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
He's taken down around the 10-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1.
Four down. Hey, alert 48. Gray 95.
Touchdown, Nittany Lions. Play ever developed nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he converts the extra point. A 6-play, 70-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 7-0. Looking for the corner. He's taken down at the 35. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Young gets it on the draw, up the middle for a nice gain.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
From their own 41-yard line, it's 2nd down. Tackle at the 41. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. And that'll bring up a punting situation.
On 3rd down, the defense was expecting the pass. And they defended the play very well in the secondary.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. taken down at the 34.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Gains his way to the 46-yard line.
There's nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. Penn State is up by a touchdown. Dumps it complete over the middle. They'll bring him down around the 43-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And the quarterback comes in and scoops up the fumble. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Hands it off. Nice run to the outside.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Throws this one out to the left. Almost intercepted.
Number five in the coverage. That'll bring up third and four.
Wants to go long and does. Incomplete. Almost picked off. He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
He's at midfield. Tackle made at the 36. Perfectly run option keeper.
Not what you'd expect when you prepare all week to defend the option. But then again, give this offense some credit. These guys aren't exactly the scout team.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 36. Penn State is up a score. Just throws this one away. Down at the 27.
That'll bring up 32.
After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Nittany Lions in front, 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Taken down around the 12-yard line.
That's a gain of 15 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 12. Complete. He's got space to work. Touchdown, Penn State! And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Heading for the corner. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. Pickoff returns 24 yards. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Fires out to his receiver, and they make the stop at the 43-yard line.
This is why it's so important to have success in running the football. It forces a defense to prepare for it, and then that creates chances on play action. They executed that one perfectly.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 43. He fights forward to about the 46.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Check, tight right.
He makes it to the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 35.
From their own 48-yard line. Third down. Plenty of time in the pocket. Steps up. And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line.
That's good decision-making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
From the 33-yard line, first down. He's out of bounds around the 30-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
After a decent run up the gut.
Gain of 5 yards. Third down.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Well, that's the second time that this defense has given up a first down on third down. You work so hard as a defense to get an offense to third down. When you get them there, you've got to be able to have somebody step up and make a big play, whether it's a defensive tackle slipping through a block, a linebacker shooting a gap, a defender in the secondary that's able to make a play on a football. Somebody's got to make a play, and that's what winning, the difference between winning a football game and losing is how you play on third down.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. Makes it to the 11.
A gain of 10 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Three down. The pass is incomplete. Smith, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up 4th and 3.
Kicks up, and he got it.
Attempt is good.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff.
Number 3, deep to return.
Taken at the 5. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The Nittany Lions are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a 4-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled right around the 34. The quarterback trying to make a play.
Well, he did a nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big hits.
They'll spread the field with five wide.
Number six was the intended receiver on the play.
Third and five coming up. Ball on the 34. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Slings it, and down he goes, right around the 42-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
He scrambled. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he's taken down around the 49-yard line.
Receiver on the play.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, go back to 48 right now. Let's go.
Ready.
They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
This is a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Easley is back deep to return the punt. And he's tackled at the 19-yard line.
Return for a gain of 6 yards.
3 points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. Makes it to the 27.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
We've played a half of football. The Nittany Lions in front, 14-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
When you don't give up any sacks, and neither team did in the first half, the offensive line gets a lot of credit and deservedly so. Quarterbacks also deserve some credit for that. They get rid of the football on time, throw it away when they need to. But a lot of times they're doing it because they don't really feel any heat from the defense.
Yeah, and defensively, you got to be able to see that. And if it's a three-step drop, then all you can do is get your hands up, try to deflect footballs. And if you're in the middle and your defensive tackle, try to push that guard as much as you can. So when that quarterback steps up, he has to step into somebody. Or how about you make them move and get outside of the pocket, you know, especially the blind side. The blind side of the quarterback, we always talk about that guy, you know, in the NFL making all the money. A lot of times you can take more risk. You can come inside on a pass rush or come outside because the quarterback can't see you. So some way, shape, or form, they got to start making sure that they make him uncomfortable and get some pressure on him.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter.
Number six, back to return.
He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 38. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets out to about the 38-yard line. So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Number 6,
He's at midfield, and he's shoved out of bounds at about the 49.
Gain of 13 on the play.
From the 49-yard line, first down. They go right, and he's tackled behind the line.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Go down, go down. Hey, check Mike 11. Check Mike 11.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. Tackle right around the 30.
Call it a gain of 20 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30. Quick shot, the defender tips it away.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
Gains his way to the 16-yard line.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play.
First and 10. Ball on the 16. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 8-play, 62-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Iowa lines up for the kickoff. Allen fields it at the 2. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 22-yard line.
Kickoff returns 20 yards.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Penn State is up by 4. He's out to the 30. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. Throws it in a hurry, and he is drilled at the 48-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Caught, open field, and they push him out around the 33-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 33. Nice run there. Sanders picks up about 4 yards on the delayed handoff.
That'll make it second and 7.
Man left, man left. Go down. Check nine.
Has some daylight. He's at the 20. He gets out to about the 17-yard line. From the 17-yard line, first down. Up the middle for a nice gain. So he calls his own number and gets about 6 yards.
That'll make it second and 4.
Penn State is up 4.
Here we go. Green 90. Green 90.
try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make plays like that.
From the 13-yard line, third down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation.
Receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and six.
It's up and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Fielded at the nine. And he's taken down at the 31. The Nittany Lions staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
Play action. He steps out at the 40. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Let's go!
Young gets the ball. They'll bring him down around the 40-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
Good stop there by the freshman. You got to be careful with this offensive attack because one missed tackle could mean trouble.
All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. Loose football, and the ball bounces out of bounds. First and 10, ball on the 45. Passes, and it's almost picked off. Receiver, and he can't make the grab. Third and long in the fourth quarter. If the defense gets a stop here, it might be a W. Oh, they really needed that one, and he dropped it. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. He fields the punt at the 13. Knocked out of bounds at about the 35. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Penn State is up by a touchdown. He's taken down around the 35-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 35. Picks up about 6 yards there.
That'll bring up third and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Hey, alert 48. Hey, go back to 48 right now. Let's go. Ready. Red 18. Red 18.
Ready. to him again, and he's going to lose yardage. Iowa is going to use their first time out of the half here. Easley is the deep man awaiting the return. He's out to the 30. He lost the ball. Picks up the fumble. Tackle made at the 33.
The defense was ready to come back on the field, but now they'll get to rest a little bit longer.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. The Hawkeyes are going to call their second timeout. From the 32-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. The Hawkeyes using their third and last timeout. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. So they pick up the first on the option. Not a lot of room there.
They go to the option here. He picks up just enough for the first. And you're right, there wasn't much running room there.
Let's go! Green 90! Green 90!
Inside the 10, he gets out to about the 8. Hoping to go up 2 touchdowns here. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Takes a knee. This one's in the books. The Nittany Lions take this one, 17-10. 17-10. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.